I have a question for you about CQRS. Do you apply it when you only work with one database too? I mean, when there is no separate database for queries already, do you apply the command and query responsibility segregation principle when working with only one database? Because CQRS itself does not require two databases. Did you know that? You can apply it anytime. And today in this video, I will show you a demo where I will apply CQRS to the application which only talks to one relational database. And the effect will be that my code will suddenly become much simpler than it was. So stay with me through the demo. You may learn something new about CQRS and its applications. This is the razor page model in a larger application, and you can observe the problem in this page already. The principal operation this page supports is the get action. We would call it a query in CQRS terms. It is a rather short method, but don't let that fool you. There is a lot more code you didn't see yet. There's also one post action handler here, which I may refer to as a command. So we have one query and one command so far here. Now that added code, all the code below this method is only supporting the get action. Not only that this code is long, but it is also very complicated at times. I could do this query much better and even more efficiently, if only I had that separation of queries and commands, which I don't have. But we will get to that point before this demo ends. You will see that some 40 lines of the nastiest code will disappear from this razor page only by separating queries from commands. I also want the razor code, which is literally HTML, to be much cleaner than it is now. Link expressions do not belong in the view. The view must not require a deep understanding of the domain model, and here I'm digging through the components of a domain model to render them. Let me show you the application running, and you will see the design issues. Try to see this page through the code you just saw. This is the introductory page that lists all the books in the bookstore. It does nothing, but it is the result of two queries. If I open one book's details, that will lead to that page which you have seen in code. It is the result of several queries, three queries to be precise, and it also supports a command to swap positions of adjacent book authors. The page is very simple when you open it. How did its code become so complex, so convoluted? I will start separating queries from commands as the first action. That will improve performance of queries and also make my code much shorter, as you will see. Before that, let me tell you that I have some coupons to share with you for video courses on Domtrain. Domtrain is an online courses platform run by fellow content creator Nick Chapsis, and it is the go-to place for up-to-date courses on modern software engineering topics. From testing to clean architecture and modular monoliths all the way to DDD, microservices, Docker, and Kubernetes, Domtrain has a rich collection of courses that will help you get up to speed with each topic by expert authors who have been practicing what they teach in real companies for years. Domtrain just launched Domtrain Pro, a subscription offering that gives access to all of the platform's courses. With more than 24,000 satisfied students, you can't go wrong with Domtrain. And the first 100 of you can use code Zoran to get 15% off any course. Back to code, I will now show you the benefits of segregating queries from commands in the ASP.NET Core application with a single relational database. That is the goal for this demo. This is the page model for the list of books. You have seen how simple that page is when I run the application, so how did it become so complicated? It is just a table with books and a row of links at the top. I'll tell you the secret. It's because I'm rendering the page from domain models. The domain model is just not made for that kind of operations, for rendering, for serialization and other similar stuff. It is made to contain complex business operations, a lot of validation, controls, things that are complicated by their nature, not to poke a name of a person and write it on the screen. We optimize domain models for commands, that is what I'm trying to tell you. This class is the domain model for a book. It is legally complex. It is full of sensitive operations, complicated operations, validations and checks. The UI doesn't care to know any of that. In an unfortunate twist of fate, this domain model is also the persistence model. I used entity frameworks to help me with persistence, so I joined the two responsibilities into one class. I'm not entirely happy with that, but it was very easy to design it that way. And now it is also the view model. Why? How did I get there? How did I get to using this bloated giant class to render HTML that is just wrong? The worst part is querying through entity framework core. For a book object to be valid, it must include authors, the person instances obtained from a many-to-many relationship, that is, two inner joins, and the optional publisher domain model object through a left outer join. Book is essentially an aggregate in terms of DDD. This project is not a DDD project, but you can watch my other video, which is explaining the elements of DDD, which we are using in everyday object-oriented design as well. There's the link in the description. This is one typical example. A book is a true aggregate, but I'm also using it as the view model. That is just wrong. So let's start correcting this situation. Aggregates support commands. So I will rename this helper extension method to communicate that better. It's because there is another form of querying, proper queries, that will not return aggregates. The query will include nothing. There will be no joins up front. Only those that we truly require in a specific query. However, the query will instruct the entity framework not to track the objects because there will be nothing to update after the query. So this is the point of separating queries from aggregates. Tracking entities would only waste resources. So this simple step completes the infrastructural support for CQRS. You can download the entire source code from this video. If you become a patron, so visit me on Patreon, you can also join the Discord server, where you will see a lot of ongoing discussions about C#. And you can find the links in the description if you're interested in downloading the source code primarily. There will be a lot of it here. I'm adding a new independent namespace for the view models alone. I could also name this namespace query models if I wanted. Now, get ready to see this implementation start melting like a polar cap in the lazy month of August. The first view model will be the essential book. Why essential? Why did I name it that way? Because it will be the stripped-down view of a book, only containing the essential information, including essential information about the authors. Let me create a query specification for this view model, and you will see why the view models are so important. I could let Entity Framework Core materialize the book models, and then map them into the view models, but that is wasteful. I don't want to work that way. I want to avoid materializing large graphs of objects when I only want to poke this property or that property from them. That is so wasteful. I want to query the database with the least resources used. And so I'm creating a specific query which maps the persistence model onto the view model. Nobody outside should be aware of this low-level database code. This is the first query segregated from commands in my solution. You may think this is less than ideal, but think again. This is the code that operates with the database. This is the infrastructural code. This doesn't even belong to the domain. The point of this code and the goal of running this code is to make the query on the database with the least resources used. Let's see what impact that will have on the page that only serves the GET action. It may seem trivial, but I will switch to using the query, not aggregates. The substantial change is below, where I will request essential book instead of domain models. Now, if you missed this detail, I have just executed the same query as before, only with one join less in the database, with fewer columns pulled from the database, and with no tracking in Entity Framework Core. The page has got more efficient, and the implementation is now a tad shorter. Now that we have warmed up, we can step to Book Details page. It consists of three queries and a command. Well, that will be a challenge. The page model in ASP.NET Core is already a view model, remember that. Your task is to put a few smaller view models inside of it. This is the final implementation, which I will now show you. It uses CQRS. The view model now only consists of a couple of smaller view models. Populating all these mini views has become straightforward. Ask one query source after another and stack the data for rendering, that's all. But again, remember, each of these queries is implemented in the best way possible. None of these makes additional joins that are not going to produce the data we render. There are no hidden methods below, so the page model ends here. I have removed 40 lines, more than 40 lines of code that existed here, and the nastiest 40 lines of code in this page model. It has become dull, it has become boring to implement it now that the queries are elsewhere. This is the command. Swapping the authors will cause a few objects to change their state, which we must persist in the database. That operation is complex. It also includes validation, checks, and whatnot. But the post action is 3 lines long. I have just succeeded in separating commands from queries in these 2 pages. All that is left is plain querying or plain commanding. I think you should definitely download the source code. There's the link in the description. You should download the source code and read what I did to enable CQRS in this application. And that is where the real story only begins, because from this point on, I can start injecting query objects, for example, like those you may know from clean architecture. That is a useful concept. I can employ it here now. The command stack is now more powerful with full aggregates in the DDD style. If you are applying or practicing DDD, you know what power of aggregates is. Now I have that power in my application. I couldn't unleash it before, but now I can. This implementation opens room for query specifications, another wonderfully powerful pattern which I can apply now to make my code even simpler, to separate querying from the domain model entirely. I can also separate the domain model from persistence model in cases where using the same aggregate as the persistence model becomes tricky or it starts causing troubles. Now I can separate the domain model from persistence model, which I couldn't do before. There's the plethora of new possibilities when application is done this way. So I will kindly ask you to start separating queries from commands in your projects, in every project you do. regardless of whether there are actually separate databases or a separate database for queries, that is not a prerequisite to CQRS. The only prerequisite is in your mind.